Stanislaw Robert Liberta here with AV Ultra, and in this lesson, we're going to be talking about four-point tracking and screen replacements in Apple Motion. You may remember we did screen replacements in a previous lesson where we were learning all about masks. In that lesson, our screen wasn't moving at all and our camera wasn't moving at all. In many other situations, our cameras are moving or our screens are moving and we need to replace them. So this lesson is all about doing that. One note about motion tracking in general that I didn't talk about before, but motion tracking isn't necessarily meant for minutes long replacements. Usually motion tracking happens pretty quickly, maybe 10, 20, even 30 seconds. That's not really what that's designed for. I just want to get that out of the way because I've heard a few people ask questions about why it's very tough or why it's very slow to track across a few minutes. I've opened up my four-point tracker's end and you can see what we have. I have my old iPhone, which just recently met a terrible demise in a moisture-related incident in Cancun. I've replaced the screen with a little bit of a logo animation and I've attached some text that comes in from the side. So really what we've done is we've tracked the motion of the screen and then I've used that same kind of track to move this text just like we did in our very first motion tracking example. Let's go ahead and open up the four-point tracker start and get started with building this out. I've opened up my four-point tracker start and right away you can see what we have. I've got my plain logo animation coming in and I just have the text flying in from the side. We've got our text an icon here with our Motion 5 icon. I also have my replacement screen that I've actually just made into a drop zone so I can drop anything I want into there. And we have our screen that we want to track. The first thing I'm going to do is just like before is select my replacement screen and we're going to go into our library, our behaviors, motion tracking, and match move. And I'm going to drop that right onto that group. And in the past, what we've done is we've used the position and the rotation. We've tracked it that way for a transformation. This time, what we're going to do is choose four corners. As soon as I hit this four corners, check out what happens in my canvas. I have four different track points in my canvas that I can maneuver. So what I want to do with this is I want to take these four track points. I'm going to go to the beginning of that comp and I'm going to place them in the corner of my screen. So I'm using the canvas and I'm using my inspector to kind of see where things are. And I can open these up, these top left, top right, and bottom left to see exactly where things are. So I'm just going to color coordinate these. I'm going to make this first one blue, the second one green. I'm going to make this one a darker blue. I'm going to make this one a purple. So I can see right away my top left is this blue and I'm going to drag that right into the corner. I'll scoot this up so I can see that a little bit clearer. And I'm going to go ahead, I'm going to make that search size a little bit bigger. I'm going to make this track size a little bit larger as well. So now it's going to be covering a larger area. And the reason for that is if I leave it at that default 32, it's probably not going to see it because it's just a little fuzzy. Now I'll do the same thing with this top right. Just pull that right about there. I'm going to make that search size a little bit bigger and the same with this track size. And I'll do the same for this bottom left. And you'll notice that it says bottom right and then bottom left. That's something that can really trip you up if you're not looking for that. I grab the bottom left first because I usually go top, top, bottom, bottom. But by default, Motion wants to go clockwise. So just be aware of that. And that's another reason why I tend to recolor my different track points. Now that we're done with our top left, can hide that, this top right. I'm just working with this one right now. And this bottom right. I'll make that search size a little bit bigger. And again, the track size a bit larger. And I can see right away, I'm not totally precise on this one right here. So I'm going to clean that up right away. The better your track from the very beginning, the better your overall results. So now that I have that, I'm going to zoom this out and we're just going to analyze this forward. Now that that's complete, I can play this back and I can see that's working out pretty good without a lot of issues. In the past, what I would tend to do is I would try to make my track sizes way too small. And what that would inevitably do, it's going to have a harder time because it's looking for a very specific group. By making my track sizes a little bit larger, it's kind of dithering out some of the extra detail that I may not need. If I review my footage, I can see the path of each one of my tracks. Because I have four tracks, it takes a little bit longer to go through the entire tracking process. But now let's take a look at exactly what it's done. Because we've used this four corner pin, I can go to my replace footage group and go to my properties. And under my properties, check out what's happening here. In my four corner that we've done before in our masking lesson with a screen replacement, I now have an animated track for each one of these X and Y coordinates for my bottom left, bottom right, and top left. I can see that they're being driven by my behavior from the match move. Right away, I've been able to screen replace this with just about a few clicks. The hardest part was just making sure that everything was lined up well. And now that I have that, let's go ahead and fine tune this a little bit. I'm going to fit this onto my screen. Right away, I can see there's a few things I want to do. Because this whole thing is grouped in one piece, I'm just going to take this and I'm going to rotate this just a tiny bit on the Z axis. And I'm going to scale that up just a little bit. So now when I play that back, it looks a little bit flatter to the screen. And I have my text come in. Now what I want to do is I want to match this text with the same kind of movement that I had here. I have my text and I want to do a match move behavior just like we did before. I'm going to delete out that move behavior for right now. And I'm just going to line this up, put this anchor point right in this corner because I know that's where I'm going to put my match move. So I'm going to go to my library, match move, drop it on my text and icon, open up my inspector. And for sure, I know I'm going to need my position and my rotation. If you pay attention to my source, right now it has my drop zone and I do not want to put that in there because I want to actually track this screen. So I'm going to take this and I'm going to place this item right in the bottom corner of the screen. And you can see that it's ignoring my drop zone right now and it's actually referencing that. And we're just going to recolor this. I'm going to make that one blue. Go to my rotation and scale, and we'll make that one purple. I'm going to take that rotation scale and put it in the top right corner of my screen. I'm going to make sure I do the same thing as I want my search area to be fairly large from frame to frame. And I want to make sure that my search size is pretty large on both of them. So right now I'm looking at my rotation scale. And we're going to place that right there. And if I click on the other one, you'll see that my other one has updated. And I'm just going to scoot him down a tiny bit. And because I'm in the middle of my timeline right now, that's all right. So I'm going to analyze that forward and it should analyze those points. And I can see that's updating in my timeline. And I'm going to go back to that very first frame that it started analyzing. We'll hit reverse and I'll analyze backwards. And now I can play that back. And I can see that that's tracking pretty well. What I want to do now is just adjust my rotation. And I'm going to go ahead and adjust that anchor point right to that corner. So now if I play that back, the last thing I want to do is I want to create a little bit of movement of this moving into the scene. So I don't want it on right away. So I'm going to go to my library, go to my behaviors and my basic motion, and we're going to put a move behavior on that. I don't want it to go across my whole scene, so I just want it right about here. And I'm going to open up my inspector. We're going to move from off screen. So I'm going to take that and we'll take the position and we're going to move it just down here. And I'm going to change that speed from a constant to an ease both. I'm just going to take this text and I'm going to move it over just a little bit. I feel like it's a little close to that. And I'll go ahead and play that back. And I feel that works a little bit better. In future lessons, we're going to take a look at what happens if we have something that isn't a rectangular piece. So that's a way that you can use the match move behavior to do screen replacements in Apple Motion. Again, my name is Stanislaw Robert Liberta with AV Ultra. Hopefully you found this tutorial useful and thanks a lot for watching. I'll see you next time.